Open defecation in Ghana has become as normal a phenomenon as it has become common. But to have a special park for open defecation in the center of a town is quite unusual. But such is the story at Ashaiman Old Tulaku.
These children here are students, but they're telling me that the toilet facility that they have is not really a toilet facility, and that is what forces them to come here to defecate. And they have just confessed to doing that, but they are hoping and praying for better. It is a spectacle that doesn't look good for the national picture of a country that has a ministry for sanitation.
Men, women and children squat in this open park every day to defecate. And they do this without worry. The park is so conspicuous that motorists on the Tema motorway can't miss it. For residents here, it is a normal phenomenon, especially for the children who patronize it. The adults shy away from speaking on record, but the children bear it all, like Abdul Rashid is doing.
When we come here to come and shit, sometimes they tell us that we should go, but we don't have public toilet so that we can shit. That's why we come here, so that we come and shit here.
And this man who is chasing you with a cane, what is his problem?
The time that we said that place, sometimes they be smoking into his part. That's why he's chasing us.
Mm. So is it that you don't have a toilet here?
Yes.
You don't have a toilet?
We have toilet, but the toilet is not good.
What is wrong with it?
Sometimes it can scatter and the shit will come out. Like it have over...
It's overflowed?
Overflowed, yes.
How do you feel about that as children growing up here?
We don't feel well. That's why. So we need help. Nana just come and help us so that we can do Ashama need. That is why we want Nana Dosh camp power so that I can do this thing. If Nana Dosh can't do it, then your mama come. You tell your mama, then your mama come and do it.
This mechanic shop owner operates right at the heart of the park. Although he denies engaging in the practice himself, he is concerned that he's in the middle of it all. Houseflies from the uncovered human excreta could easily fly and settle on food sold and served to consumers here. But that does not seem like a bother for the slum dwellers here.
I used to clean here. Mm. You understand? Every time for here, I'm cleaning here.
But it's easy for a housefly to just fly from that place.
No. I didn't experience that. When I steam down here, they blow everywhere, so you cannot see any flies. So,
yeah, but you don't use
no,
this
no,
place.
No, no,
what
no.
do you use?
I didn't do what?
Wait, is there a toilet in this area that you use?
No, toilet there around this area. So I'll go
in. Why don't people go there? You know?
Oh, for me, I don't know. Me and my boys or everybody. When you fail to go toilet, I'll give you money to go in. You understand? Toilet 70 pesos, 50 pesos.
Okay. Looking at what is in there, it explains clearly why people would resort to the park nearby. It is not a better alternative as a toilet. That is the problem here. People may want to use a toilet, maybe because of dignity and so on, but there is no dignity in that cubicle I'm just coming out from. It is smelly, stinky, filthy, dirty, and disgusting, as well as nauseating. Curious case is that this toilet, again, it is supposed to be a public toilet that was built for the people who live here. But if you looked at the walls here, it says, remove now by Ashma. Now, Ashma is the Ashama Municipal Assembly, and this is supposed to be removed by 20th February 2019, within 14 days. Now, on February 2019, if the Ashama Municipal Assembly said it should be removed in 14 days, it is curious to ask and wonder why this toilet still sits here.
People like Rashid, who claim they use this toilet, want it replaced.
Some of the hustling, maybe the place I sleep safe, I know if we do toilet for there. Unless here I can't make my toilet. Where at times if we come here, the toilet will make like this, no, I will come out. because of the toilet, you know, needs. Like, we like, make they come do one better for us. Make they know cleaner, make they leave them, then they can make them well for us. Because if they clean, if they scatter them, some people do some place, they go feel calm the shit, it go worry them. Make they leave them, then they do them small, small. Like, we like, make they come do one better for us. Make they know cleaner, make they leave them, then they can make them well for us.
The problem with public toilets of this nature is that because of the stench, users would usually light a cigarette before entering. The smoke from the cigarette, however, even though useful for the smokers, is a put-off for non-smoking users, as Little Abdulrahman explains. In a rather shocking turn of events, the assembly member for this electoral area, Yakubu Amadu, says this park, which serves as a free zone for persons engaging in open defecation, was meant to be a recreational center.
We have not asked anybody to do any open defecation. We have spoken against it. So whoever is held will be held capable to it.
But it is cleared. Who cleared it? For what purpose?
Assembly cleared it for recreational purposes. People who want to train, people who want to do physical training, whatever. Yes.
So it's supposed to be a football park?
Yes. Not only for football.
What
but
else?
Any time that you feel you must go and relax, or any time you want to, you do physical training to get your body fit.
The Akufo-Addo-led government says it is committed to the attainment of the Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs Goal 6, which borders on water, sanitation and hygiene. Among the steps taken in the water, sanitation and hygiene sector, that is a wash sector, is the creation of the new Ministry for Sanitation and Water. There is also a grand government plan to make Accra the cleanest city in Africa by 2020. But ugly scenes like the one at Ashaiman, a major city in the Greater Accra region, does not show enough steps have been taken. The Gamma project, which is facilitating the construction of toilets for residents as a subsidized fee, is ongoing. Some of the toilets, like this one located at Ashaiman New Town, seems like a glimmer of hope. Henry Tenu is the environmental health officer for the Ashaiman Municipal Assembly. He says people are patronizing the project.
From the beginning, it has not been easy because, you know, behavioral change is very difficult to change. But as sensitization always goes on, they've come to realize that this new technology is sustainable. It has urged them to come for more facilities.
How much is it?
For the stand alone, as you can see, the full cost is 4,000, but the subsidized cost is 1,001. So they are supposed to pay 1,001 for the facility.
The trip to Ashaiman was organized by the Media Coalition Against Open Defecation, MCODE, with support from the Coalition of NGOs in Water and Sanitation, CONIWAS. Veteran journalist and national patron of MCODE, Dr. Doris Yadati, explains why the group decided to embark on the field trip.
We have a long way to go as a country. There's so much work to do. Earlier in the day, we visited Tulaku, and the entire community smells bad. It's not habitable. The air is polluted in the area. So then right now we are in a better situation. It's cleaner, but still more work needs to be done.
At the Ashaiman Municipal Assembly, Municipal Coordinating Director Kojo Ekwuama Boateng recounts some more worrying statistics to the team of journalists.
According to the Urban Wash Baseline Report in 2016, only 15.7% of household users improve sanitation facilities. 83.9% depends on the public and shared toilet facilities. 0.2% use open pit, and 0.2% practice open defecation. That is an improvement over 4% that was recorded in 2010. I'm talking about people practicing open defecation.